something?
Yeah.
You have a minute?
Yeah.
And just tell me if anything that I say to you doesn't make sense.
Okay.
Do you understand how when smart people by nature, the smartest people in any society, they will do the most important jobs? Okay, nodding yes. Next question. Do you know that Jews are even the smartest people on earth? Yes, you say. Okay. Can you understand how if Jews were traveling from country to country, they would by nature take over very important social structures in the country? Does that make sense?
Well, if they're the smartest people, yeah, they should take over all the jobs.
They should take over the important jobs. So as they were in Golis, as they were in exile going from country to country, they by nature took over very important jobs in the countries that they went to.
Right.
So from understanding this first principle, that Jews are smart, so and by nature brains take over, and if Jews were also exclusive, you know what the word exclusive means?
I don't know how to put it into a word.
Exclusive means very selective. Only wanting who we are. Only wanting a specific group, a small group. If a store is exclusive, if it's called an exclusive store, it means it doesn't take everyone as a customer. Even only a certain type of person will they take as a customer. Say, people who are very rich.
Yeah.
So because Jews, they made it very hard to convert, to become Jewish, you know that, right?
Yeah.
So because of that, they were very exclusive, not going to other people's houses to eat, say, in the countries that they went to, etc., etc. So they were very tight-knit. Exclusive is a way of saying very tight-knit, okay? So if by nature the Jews were going from country to country, and because they were so smart, they were taking over important social structures in the country, and at the same time being exclusive, keeping to themselves, not going to other people's houses to eat, etc., etc., by nature, you can see how there would be anti-Semitism from the jobs, say, the important structures that they were taking over, because at the same time, they weren't letting people in. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So now you understand how there can be anti-Semitism, even by nature.
Yeah.
Good. Add to that another thing. So you know that, as it says in the Chumash, in the Torah, that one day the heart of man will be turned from hard-heartedness to soft-heartedness, from a lev even to a lev basar. You know this, right?
Yes.
Has this happened yet? Is it considered that this has happened, that this nevuah has yet come true, or is it meant to come true when Mashiach comes? It's considered that this happens when Mashiach comes. Mankind's heart is still hard-hearted because there's so many wars, there's so many people starving on one side of the world, and another side of the world, so many people living in the utmost luxury when there's enough for everyone. So it hasn't yet happened when the hearts of the Jews and also the hearts of all humanity has been changed from a very hard heart to a soft, loving heart. It hasn't yet happened. Okay? So now let's go back to what we discussed, that the Jews, because they're so smart, going from country to country, taking over important social structures, and if they're also very selective, very exclusive, so they're not so much having interactions with the other people, you can see how there would be anti-Semitism, that those people would think even that there was a conspiracy by the Jews to take over, etc., etc. So if on top of that, the Jews didn't yet have a loving heart, but they were still hard-hearted, it makes the anti-Semitism even more so, because there could even be anti-Semitism even if the Jews were concerned about everyone. But because they weren't yet concerned about everyone, it makes the anti-Semitism even more, because they won't care as much. They'll be taking over, they'll be getting more control of resources, and they won't be caring as much about the other people that they'll be keeping out. So you can see how there's even more anti-Semitism. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Oh, good. So the secret is to change the heart of the Jews to a loving, caring heart. And then the world will love us. Why? Because if the Jews are the smartest, what does that mean?
They can help us.
That's right. They can help everyone, right, for the benefit of humanity. They could make the best medicine. They could take us to the stars. Or we can, because we're Jews too. We could use our brains for the benefit of everyone, including us. So that's why there's Nevuah, there's prophecy that one day everyone will love the Jews. When will it happen? When the hearts of the Jews have been turned to flesh.
And
made
because
love.
Of that, Mashiach will come.
And Mashiach brings it. Yes. How to get to this loving heart is one to recognize that love by nature is the greatest feeling. How old are you?
15.
Okay, good. I'm glad you recognize that when you're 15. But love is the greatest feeling for men, for women, for boys, for girls, for everyone. But you know, if somebody gives love, cares about the wrong person, they can get burned. You know that? Like, let's say someone had a friend, and they were always there when the friend needed them, and then something happened to the person, and then when they turned to their friend, who they always taken care of, the friend turned their back on them, didn't care. So what happened? To the first person who really cared, they can get angry. And then their heart could get hard. And then they could not so easily love someone else or care about someone else in the future, because the first time when they did it, they got hurt. And then you can't love as much. So what one has to do, they have to give their love to the right person. See, they have to be very smart to know who to care about so that the person will be there for them in the future. They have to make a proper investment. Have you heard that the way of Mashiach is little baby steps? Have you heard that said?
I didn't hear the exact thing, but...
Okay, that's what they say. Regarding Mashiach, the Messiah's coming, they say he comes, it's little baby steps. One reason why it's said is because of this. Because in order to get to the loving heart that stays a loving heart, you have to give your love to the right person without getting burned by it. Because if somebody gives love to the wrong person and then they get hurt, then they can't love as much in the future. You see? So you have to trust someone. But how to trust someone without getting burned is by building faith in somebody. And how do you build faith by nature?
Baby steps.
Baby steps, you're right. You see, little by little. Do you see? If you know every day they're going to be responsible, reliable, then you can start to build faith in them. So, that's...
Also, you could also say that you have to break out of your baby habits.
What do you mean, break out of your baby habits?
Like, babies always say, that's mine.
Good. Good. Right. What's your name? Who are
Moshe
you?
Moshe Feinstein.
Ah, Moshe Feinstein! You're like the neshama of Moshe Feinstein come back. Who are you?
Great-grandson.
Your great-grandson. And who is your father?
Reb Beryl Feinstein.
Ah, Beryl is your father. I know Beryl. This was super. This was a nice. Say hi to Beryl from Chaim Yehuda Gruber. Say hi to your father.
All right.
Okay? So thank you, Moshe.
You're welcome.
Okay. Bye.
Thank you.
Amen. Kam lecha.